an improved game center allows you to handpick which notifications to pass through when you are gaming. It now supports WeChat voice integration, so no more switching to WeChat if you get a call. Finally, there are various screen off gestures available, allowing you to launch apps without even unlocking the phone. Those are hardly more than a gimmick though, particularly given how quickly the Oppo F9 unlocks performance and benchmarks. The Oppo F9 employs the same chipset powering the Oppo F7 and R15, the Helio P60, the MediaTek P60, packs when enabled full screen gesture navigation positions three small lines at the bottom of the UI, but you can choose to hide those lines swiping up from the middle one X like a home button. But if you stop the gestures midway, you'll summon the task switcher like on the iPhone X, swiping on the left or right one's X as back. You can change one of those to open the recent apps manager if you like. We sure did. An octa-core processor with 4x Cortex A73 at 2.0 GHz cores and 4x Cortex A53 at 2.0 GHz cores. The presence of A73 cores is a serious boost the Android's day-to-day operations. There is a triple core Mali G72 GPU to handle graphics. We already know this is not the best in the mid-range class, but it's no disaster either. The Oppo F9 comes with either 4 GB or 6 GB of RAM in India, with the latter being sold as F9 Pro there. Outside India, the F9 is available only with 6 GB RAM, much like our unit. The camera app offers the so-called AI Boost, which is a fancy name for scene recognition. You'll see a small icon when a scene is successfully recognized, and the software will tweak all settings accordingly. Food, snow, pets, dogs and cats, sunsets, grass, among other scenes, are identified mostly correctly. The interface of the camera app has borrowed a lot from the iOS app. Most settings are on the left or top, depending on the orientation, while different modes are selected on the right or bottom, next to the shutter key. The app offers two trendy modes: dash 2x telephoto zoom and blurred background. The 2x mode have a dedicated shortcut on the Oppo F9, packs a dual camera on its back, although the 16MP primary sensor behind bright f/1.8 lens does all of the lifting, with the 2MP secondary unit being a mere depth sensor. Phase detection autofocus is available, and there is a single LED flash next to those cameras, the viewfinder, but the zoom is purely digital zoom. The portrait mode is on the Rolodex, and it uses the secondary 2MP cam for depth information. There are a few settings, including location tagging and guidelines, separated out in their own menu. In the phone settings, there is a total lack of any clear resolution control for stills. All you get is a choice of aspects between the standard 4:3:1, 1:1, and 16:9. At first glance, it's unclear which aspect ratio is native to the sensor, and you have to go through some trial and error until you see that 4:3 shots give you the most resolution. Expert mode is available for those seeking more manual controls. It comes with a handy horizon level and can change most settings on the primary camera. This mode doesn't work with the selfie cam. The main sensor is nothing to phone home about, really. 1/3.1 in size with 1.0 micrometers pixels. In fact, it's smaller than the 25MP selfie snapper with its 1/2.8 size and 0.9 micrometers pixels. The shutter speed control offers fine adjustment and it's good mostly for very low light shooting. It starts at 1s and increments at full stops to a maximum of 16s. Manual focus adjustment is present as well. Image quality: in good light, the Oppo F9 images turned out nice with enough resolved detail, excellent contrast, and accurate colors. The dynamic range is slightly above average. There are clipped highlights here and there, but nothing that the auto HDR can't fix. The noise is all well controlled, an improvement over the Oppo F7. The foliage presentation also got better since the F7, but the grass is still often smudgy. Selfies: Oppo F series phones used to be self-named selfie experts, but the company has dialed down on the use of that particular title. Despite this, the F9 features a high-res 25MP selfie cam identical to the one on the Oppo F7. It doesn't have autofocus, which is rather disappointing though. The Oppo F9 supports the so-called 3HDR tech for the selfie camera. It's a combination of tricks that results into better HDR selfies, with the HDR effect applied in real time and visible on the viewfinder. You can turn that off if you like. Disable the HDR auto, but we'd recommend leaving it on. It does a good job. The 25MP resolution might sound impressive, but the actual resolved detail is hardly great, and if you miss the sweet spot of the fixed focus, you'd get slightly blurred images. The colors and contrast are great, though, and whatever the shortcomings, those pictures would look perfect once downsampled to any other size thanks to the impressive 25MP resolution. The Pocophone F1 by Xiaomi clearly managed to shake things up around the mid-range, offering a flagship-grade Snapdragon 845 chipset without at an unbelievable price. You also get 4K video recording, an IR camera, powered face unlock and stereo speakers. So if you are a power user, it's hard to ignore it. Yet, the F1 doesn't come even close to matching the F9 looks, nor its 20 watts VOOC charging. The Honor Play also costs the same as the Oppo F9 and is another handset obsessed with performance. It has metal now. The F9 isn't a huge upgrade over the F7, and that's hardly a surprise given that its predecessor is just 6 months old. We can't see F7 owners jumping ship, but the F9 was never meant to entice those. Instead, it was meant to keep the line relevant in a segment where new competitors are coming in every week to the F1's plastic, but again isn't attractive in the same way the F9 is. Oh, and the notch is on. That one, much like the Poco phone. F1 is huge and unsightly, so. It's not just about the looks of the back. The Vivo V11, an in-house rival, has a better Super AMOLED screen with a similar notch and under-display fingerprint scanner to brag about, in addition to the equally cool body and arguably better camera. It misses on the Gorilla Glass 6 protection though, and that futuristic fingerprint reader is rather unreliable. Finally, the Mi A2 is all about the stock Android experience. It's got an equally capable chipset and better cameras on the back, but a far less imaginative design and no microSD card slot. The verdict: the Oppo F9 is among the most attractive in the mid-range today. Unique with that water drop-like notch and beautiful with the gradient back with cool pattern underneath. If you are a power user, you will certainly find better phones than the F9 for the same price, but if you also care about design, Oppo's latest will certainly fit the purpose better, while still providing a solid smart experience. Pros: Gorilla Glass 6 protection for the screen, a large display with excellent contrast and beautiful notch, excellent battery life, VOOC charging. The Helio P60 isn't a beast, but it gets the job done. Cons: plastic frame, no 4K video recording, mediocre 1080p clips, another microSD port.
Follow us. Google search. www.googlesearch.co.in. Facebook/blog2page/. www.facebook.com/weblink. Twitter.com/blog2bebd. Twitter.com/weblink. If you like this video, click like icon and share your friends.
If you want more best videos, please subscribe and click bell icon.